Welcome back to our ongoing series, where we explore key financial metrics. Today, our focus is the Omega ratio. And in this lesson, we will analyze its role and why it's important in formulating investment strategies. If you're committed to gaining a deeper understanding of finance, this is a must-listen tutorial. Let's get started. The Omega ratio is a risk-return performance measure of an investment asset, portfolio, or strategy. It was devised by Con Keating and William F. Shadwick in 2002 and is defined as the probability-weighted ratio of gains versus losses for some threshold return target. Think of the Omega ratio as a sophisticated way to weigh the probabilities of gains against losses, all set against a chosen target return. The higher the Omega ratio, the better the chances of winning over losing. But that's not all. The Omega ratio also takes into account the skewness and kurtosis of the return distribution, giving us insights into how asymmetrical and peaked the distribution is, something that other ratios like the Sharpe ratio might overlook. So, how do we calculate the Omega ratio? It's all about capturing the cumulative excess return of an asset, which means tracking the ups and downs of the asset's returns over time and comparing this to our target return. This target could be anything we choose, a risk-free rate, a market index, or another benchmark. To calculate the Omega ratio, we take the sum of all the gains, called winning excess returns, and divide it by the absolute sum of all the losses, or losing excess returns. Let's break this down with an example. Imagine we have a portfolio with returns over 10 periods and we're targeting a return of 7%. The difference between the return we actually get and our target is what we call the excess return. For instance, during the first period, we subtract our target of 7% from the actual return of 8%, giving us an excess return of 1%. During the fifth period, our return is 2%, which is less than our target. Subtracting our target from the actual return, we end up with a negative excess return of minus 5%. We label positive excess returns as wins, and the negative ones as losses. Adding these up gives us sum of winning excess returns, 11%, and sum of losing excess returns, minus 21%. To get the Omega ratio, we divide the sum of wins by the absolute sum of losses. This gives us a ratio of 0.53. The Omega ratio less than 1 means that the asset or portfolio has performed poorly relative to the target and has more downside risk than upside potential. A table of excess returns can tell you how much an investment has earned or lost compared to a target over individual periods. However, the Omega ratio looks at the bigger picture. It shows you not only the potential gains or losses against a target return, but also the likelihood of those outcomes. For instance, two investments may have the same average excess return, but one may have a higher Omega ratio. This happens when there's a lower chance of losses and a higher chance of gains. In such cases, that investment would be more attractive, all other things being equal. Think about the Omega ratio as a financial compass. A negative reading implies our investment is drifting away from our desired return, with losses outweighing gains. On the contrary, a positive Omega ratio shows our investment is on the right path, delivering more gains than losses relative to our expected goal. The greater the Omega ratio, the more frequently our investment yields gains over losses at a certain benchmark. Therefore, a higher Omega ratio is often favored by investors, acting as a beacon towards potential success. To make this concept easier to understand for non-traders, let's use a simple real-world example. Picture yourself participating in a dice game that costs $5 to play. In the first game, you stand to win $10 if you roll a 6, which has a 1 in 6 chance. Any other roll results in a loss of $5. In the second game, your chances are better, you win $5 if you roll a 4, 5, or 6, that's a 50-50 chance. However, rolling anything under 4 still means losing your $5. In both games, your goal is simply to break even. Now, imagine you play each game 10 times. In the first game, you strike lucky twice by rolling a 6, earning you $10 each time. On the flip side, the dice lands on 2 for the remaining 8 rolls, which costs you $5 each time. The overall gain or positive excess return is $20, while the total loss, also known as the absolute negative excess return, clocks in at $40. This math gives us an omega ratio of 0.5. Transitioning to the second game, you hit a 4 on 4 occasions, netting you $5 each time. However, for the rest of the 6 rolls, a 2 shows up, setting you back $5 each time. Even though the total gain is identical to the first game at $20, the total losses are lower, totaling $30. This results in a slightly better omega ratio of 0.67. Interestingly, even though the sum of winnings from both games is identical, the omega ratio tilts in favor of the second game. This is indicative of a better risk-reward trade-off, thanks to more frequent wins. The real charm of the omega ratio is its ability to factor in not just the wins and losses, but also the probability of these outcomes. This gives us a more holistic view of our investment. The omega ratio is a useful tool for investors to compare different assets, portfolios, or strategies based on their risk-return profile. It takes into account the entire distribution of returns, not just the mean and the variance. It also allows investors to choose their own target return and see how the asset performs relative to that benchmark. However, the omega ratio also has some limitations, such as being sensitive to the choice of target return and being difficult to optimize. I trust this episode has shed some light on the concept of the omega ratio and how you can calculate it. If you found it helpful, do show your support by liking this video and sharing it with others who might benefit. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button to stay updated with more informative financial content from our channel. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next episode. Bye.